advertising come in all shapes and sizes, unlike the original and oldest form of advertising for pubs in England. Because there are so many different types of advertisement nowadays, there are groups that work to regulate what can and cannot happen. This group of people who lobby Congress is known as the Outdoor Advertising Association of America. The need for greater brand awareness has contributed to the amount of money being spent by advertisers, as well as the variety of outdoor formats that have become available. In 2008 alone, advertisers spent $8.4 billion. Lady Bird was the first lady from 1963 to 1969. She was devoted to highway and city beautification and pushed the bill to Senate to have the Highway Beautification Act passed in 1965. This act restricted placement of outdoor signs along interstate highways and drastically reduced the number of billboards along interstates. Most signs are now in commercially zoned areas only. In 1980, one-third of all advertisements featured tobacco products. In 1999, tobacco advertisements were banned as part of an agreement with 46 state attorney generals and major tobacco companies. Although liquor and cigarettes used to be the medium, image advertising is on the rise, with a diversified range of products limited only by law and imagination. Most money is spent on outdoor ads by McDonald's and Verizon and AT&T. 66% of outdoor ads are billboards. 16% of out-of-home ads are alternatives, such as 8-sheet, 30-sheet, and bulletins. 11% are seen on transit, and 7% are seen on street furniture, such as bus stops and phone booths. Poster panels are the most widely used format of outdoor advertising because they are cost-effective and enable you to put your messages in more locations for longer periods of time. That means you can stretch your ad budget and get max exposure to a huge target audience. Poster panels used to be small paper panels or painted, but now they are just a single giant sheet of vinyl, which is still referred to as 30-sheet posters. These posters stretch 48 feet wide and 14 feet high. 8-sheet posters are about one-third the size of regular poster panels. They are often used by smaller brands and placed closer to the road. Rotary bulletins, not to be confused with TriVision, are boards that are moved to different high-traffic locations at fixed intervals to achieve maximum exposure. These boards are four times as expensive as posters. Spectaculars are one-of-a-kind outdoor advertisements. They are designed for specific spots, normally in urban centers, where they attract maximum attention. TriVisions are a type of outdoor advertisement with a slatted face that allows three different copy messages to revolve at intermittent intervals. TriVisions are normally located at intersections and run for about half the price of a regular poster panel. CBS and Clear Channel were the first to roll out digital billboards. Now nationwide networks of billboards allow advertisers to change their sales pitches instantly and make real-time changes. Giant LED billboard ads rotate every few seconds, enabling billboard owners to sell the same space multiple times. This new technology can even be used by police in case of emergencies. Other types of outdoor advertisements that you'll see in the pictures that follow are for bus stops, benches, trucks, mall advertisement, phone booths, and even tables. I know the day. When buying outdoor ad space, it is important to be familiar with GRP and DEC. GRP is gross rating point. This is the total number of impressions delivered by a media schedule expressed as a percentage of a market population. For example, 1 GRP represents 1% of the population. It is important to remember that you cannot compare GRPs in different markets. DEC is daily effective circulation. It is a complex formula that involves traffic statistics, and when calculated, gives you the average number of persons passing and potentially exposed to an advertising display for either 12 or 24 hours. By subscribing to the TAB, also known as the Traffic Audit Bureau, advertisers can get valuable knowledge about how many people pass each board each day. Keep in mind, outdoor advertising has pros and cons. Some of the pros are that it has a high exposure rate, reaching virtually every adult, and also attention-getting abilities using color and lighting. Some of the cons, on the other hand, are that you must keep your message brief because of high-speed drivers, which give you distracted attention at best. Legislative controls, which measure vision pollution and controversial messages, are also a constraint on outdoor advertisements.